I'm still in Colorado and I've been feeling really sick for the past week and my stomach pain has come back. So Bella's come back to look after me and help me. But this morning I started having chest pains too, and it's getting worse. And my whole body is. I'm swelling up and losing control of my bladder. So that's all scaring me, and I'm really worried what that means. But I know it probably can't be good.
What's going on? What hurts?
Chest is tight. It hurts so bad. Like my shoulder blades hurt. Like up here hurts. Like someone's sitting on it. I don't know what's going on with me. It's cutting off the circulation of my leg.
And I also
peed my bed twice last night. I'm so full of water, I can't even fucking walk. That's why I'm on this towel. I don't even feel good enough to like take my sheets off my bed. It's disgusting. Like I literally just cannot move around and do anything. And I'm afraid something's happening with my heart. And I'm scared. I'm scared it's congestive heart failure. So I'm gonna call the ambulance.
Make sure you tell them that you need a bariatric hospital.
I've been in the hospital for around 6 weeks now. After they ran all their tests and everything, the good news was my body wasn't breaking down or anything that I was afraid of at that time. But I still have so many health issues related to my weight, so they haven't felt like it's been safe to send me home. Doctor now wants them to put me on a controlled diet here, but it turns out they don't really do that, or at least not how Doctor now wants. He's been checking in on me and some of my treatments, and I have a video call with him today.
Hey, Sam. How you doing?
I'm all right.
I'm just gonna get a weight on you.
Does this have to be off?
All right, looks like 940 this morning. Okay.
That's not good news.
Anything I can do for you right now?
Nope. Okay. That's it.
See you soon.
Thanks, Allison.
You're welcome.
Hi, Samantha.
Hi.
How you doing?
I've seen better days, but I'm doing okay, relatively.
So I see that you're still in the hospital, huh?
Yep, because I've developed some new health issues.
Like what issues?
Skin has been a big problem right now. My right side is bigger. It's so full of fluid that the pores, I don't really have wounds over there. The pores themselves are just weeping fluid.
And they just put chucks under me and let me just weep all over it.
Well, that all sounds pretty bad. So your health is still deteriorating rapidly, and being in that bed all the time is not helping that. What is your mobility?
I can still stand, I can still walk, but I have to use a walker.
Okay, so what is your weight now?
As of this morning, it was 940.
So in a month and a half, you put on almost another 150 pounds?
Yeah.
So you realize that your weight is getting to a very dangerous point right now, and you're running out of time.
I know.
So why are you gaining more weight while you're in the hospital?
Well, I wasn't really following any kind of a diet plan.
I mean, that's my problem. And
I have to be completely frank with you. I'm sneaking food around.
Well, I have emailed you the diet plan.
And talked to the hospital.
About putting restrictions on your food to help you do that. But so far, that hasn't worked.
Yeah, so they just recently put me on a 2,100 calorie a day diet.
So 700 calories a meal. And then,
yeah.
That's not the diet plan you need to be on. But even if you're eating
2,100 calories,
you would have lost a lot of weight. But you're still eating
around 10 to 12,000 calories a day on top of being on bed rest.
So this is a bad situation where you're just going to
gain more weight and get more weight. You won't be able to get up and walk. You're almost hitting around 1,000 pounds, huh?
Yeah.
It's impressive. You can still stand up at almost 1,000 pounds. But being bedridden at your weight, there'll be no way you can survive long.
And it sounds like your body is already giving out. So I'm going to send you the 1,200 calorie diet again. Okay? And try to follow that.
Which means?
No snacking, you only
eat 3 times. Eat only about 400 calories per meal. You can have the cooked vegetable and salad.
And 4 to 6 ounces of meat with that.
I'm just really scared. Like, I'm overwhelmed right now.
It's gonna be a lot of things. Food is my entire life.
I don't know what I am without food.
I'm sorry.
No need to apologize.
This isn't an easy process, and it's always scary to take the first steps to change like this.
But remember, as important as food is to you, your life is more important than food. And if you don't make these changes now, then you're going to kill yourself with the food. You get that?
Yep, for sure.
All right. Well, nice talking to you, and we'll be in touch. And if you have any questions, give me a call.
Okay, sounds like a plan.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
These past months have been a huge change for me, because getting weight loss surgery saved my life. When the stay-at-home stuff started, I started to get scared I wasn't going to be able to get weight loss surgery. So I was very excited when I found out that I was going to get it here in Denver. So I got it a few months ago, and I've been here in the hospital the whole time because I twisted my knee coming back and couldn't be on my own again with how much I've gained. So I wasn't expecting to be in the hospital this long.
So it's working. I'm exercising more, I'm losing weight.
Because I'm down to 638 as of this morning. That's the lowest I've been in like 15 years.
But I am miserable and depressed right now, which I cannot figure out.
Except for the fact that I don't know how to cope with my life and existence without food.
People kept saying, it's not gonna be as bad as you think, it's not gonna be as bad. But it's even harder than I thought it was going to be.
If food makes me happy, the happy me is gone. I just feel incredibly sad.
Oh, okay. It says 280.2, so this is in kilogram. I'm just going to do a quick calculation. Oh, my God, look, 616 pounds. Good job.
Yay.
Wow.
From 950, 970.
970, yeah. 970. Wow. This is really good. So proud of you. But you're not done, okay?
Not done.
You are not done. You're gonna get below 500.
Below 500.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Okay. Great job.
Today, Samantha is being discharged to rehab after being in the hospital for a while.
Wanna get off on that side of the bed?
Everybody's peering. I'm not an orangutan, guys. Just a really large human. Yeah, I'll come
outside. We're only going to be able to keep Sam in rehab for about a month, maybe a little bit longer. But now that Sam has completed the physical stress of surgery and has come through the surgery so well, it's important for her to get serious about the emotional aspect of this problem and her issues. She's going to rehab to work with physical therapy and also work with behavioral specialists, with psychotherapy, to really help her continue with weight loss. She needs those as support now that she's done so well with surgery.
After my most recent surgery, the wounds refused to heal, and so I was sent to a rehab facility, and this is where I'm at right now. It's a small setback, but by this time next year, I will have my life back. I worked way too hard to be at this point in my life right now to give up. And I will not be giving up. My spirits are up, and I'll have my cats and my kid, and everything will be in my life that I want to be in my life next year. These wounds are not it. They will not be in my life. I can't see me stopping at this point. This will have all been for nothing if I stop now. So just a small setback.